everyone. In this video, we are going to see like how to determine whether a given system is causal or non-causal. First, you should know what is a causal system. A causal system means here the output at the present instant will depend upon the present input as well as the past input. It is independent of the future input. So, for a non-causal system means the output is the output depending upon the future input also. So, we will see the first problem. Y of t is equal to 3 of x of 3t. So, if your problem is given, to find the output at 3 time instants. One is at time t is equal to 0, another one for a positive instant, another one for a negative instant. So, here we are taking t is equal to 0 means we are finding what is y of 0. Y of 0 is equal to x of 0. So, that output at the present instant depends upon the present input. The next one, t is equal to 1 means y of 1 is equal to x of 3 into 1, that is x of 3. So here the output at this instant depends upon x of 3 means future input. It depends upon future input. When t is equal to minus 1, y of minus 1 is equal to x of minus 3. So we are finding what is y of minus 1, that is output at t is equal to minus 1. It depends upon x of minus 3 means it depends upon the output when input is equal to minus 3 means this is the past input. So, the output for this particular system depends upon the present, past and the future input. So, here the output depends upon future input means the given system is a non-causal system. The second problem we are taking here, seeing here is y of t is equal to e power x of t. So, again we substitute 3 time instants and find what is the respective output. So, when t is equal to 0, y of 0 is equal to e power x of 0. When t is equal to 1, y of 1 is equal to e power x of 1. When t is equal to minus 1, y of 1 is equal to e power x of minus 1. Each and every instant, the particular output depends upon one leading particular present input. So, the given system is a causal system. The third problem we are going to see is y of n is equal to x of 1 minus x of n minus 2. So, again, we have to find what is the output at 3 time instances. N is equal to 0 means n is equal to 0 means y of 0 is equal to substitute for n is equal to 0. This is a DT system they have given. So x of 0 minus x of minus 2. X of 0 means this is the present input. X of minus 2 means this is the past input. So output at n is equal to 0 depends upon present as well as the past input. When n is equal to 1, you find what is y of 1. That is x of 1 minus x of minus 1. Again, this is present input and this is past input. Substitute n is equal to minus 1. So y of minus 1 is equal to x of minus 1 minus x of minus 1. This is present, this is past input. So here for each and every case, the output depends upon the present as well as the past input. So the given system is a causal system. So the last problem we are going to see in this session is y of n is equal to x of n square. Again, you substitute different values for n. So n is equal to 0 means x of 0. So the output at this instant depends upon the present input. When y is equal to 1 means this is x of 1. Again, it depends upon present input alone. So, this is a square, n square given. So, if n is equal to 1 means n square is 1. So, you substitute the next 1. N is equal to 2. So, we are getting x of 4. So, the output at n is equal to 2 depends upon the input at n is equal to 4. That is the future input. Again, you substitute n is equal to minus 1 and minus 2. So, in this last case again, the output at n is equal to minus 2 depend upon the future input. So, ultimately if you see the given system, the output depends upon the present as well.